Why did you do it? Harvey needed you. Why save me?
I haven't actually seen it yet. You've had me wrapped up this whole time. Numbed beyond belief. Maybe it's not that bad.
Our stock is tanking. The board is losing confidence. Wayne Enterprises needs a new face. Oswald Cobblepot.
You're the only ally I have in this building. It's important. I need you to be my eyes and ears.
All right, I can do that.
Keep Oswald out of R&D, and let me know if anything comes up.
You're a good man, Bruce.
Please, Selina, I have to tell you how I...
Bruce?
You should come stay with me.
I'll think about it.
Dropped your pen?
It's not...
Arkham.
Face the truth sometime.
Retribution, Bruce.
Okay, I'm up.
For Christ's sake, put some clothes on. Doctor's making the rounds soon.
Doctor? What doctor? Arkham Asylum. This can't be happening. Can't be real. Is that my blood? God, I hope it's mine. Looks like someone was angry. Lovely.
Better be decent. You settled? Good. Anything you need? Water? Piss? Rat poison? I've been asked for rope before. Not really allowed to give it out. Of course, I could make an exception for you.
You can tell me why I'm in Arkham Asylum for a start.
What? Rich boy doesn't remember? Oswald Cobblepot? You beat him to a bloody pulp. Nearly killed him. Landed you here. Any of this ringing a bell? Might as well get comfortable. This is your home now. Time to meet your neighbors. As you were.
You look just like him. Your father ever tell you about me? How he sent me here? Left me to rot in this goddamn hellhole? Somebody's gotta pay for that. I hope to God there is a hell. I want your daddy to see what I do to you.
I am so sick of everyone blaming me for what my father did. I'm not him. Hurting me does nothing.
Maybe not, but you're the next best thing, Wayne.
Appreciate the help.
You're welcome. If we don't look out for each other, who will, right?
What is going on in here?
It's like I told you, Doctor. These creeps were attacking the new guy.
Well, who did that? Was it you?
Of course not. It was mostly over by the time I got in. The new guy's tougher than he looks. Right, buddy?
Bruce, is that really what happened?
Go on, tell her.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what happened.
We have a very strict no-fighting policy here in Arkham. If you can't obey that rule, you're going to find yourself in hot water fast.
The orderly that was here before took money from these men and let them into my room. He gave them a taser.
I knew that you coming to Arkham could cause some excitement, but I didn't expect it to happen so fast. I'll do my best to keep you safe, but I need you to be careful.
Us nice guys gotta stick together. Am I right?
Come to me if anything happens.
Thank you. I appreciate the effort.
I'm glad you're so understanding after what just happened. Good thing help wasn't far away.
Hey, I'm just looking out for the new guy.
I'm Dr. Joan Leland, by the way, head of psychiatry. I'll be overseeing your case personally. We'll get you transferred to a new room, Bruce. One that doesn't have your blood all over it. For now, follow me.
I'm sorry, I don't think I ever got your name.
Me?
He's never given his name out to anybody.
What?
We just call him John Doe.
Bingo.
John is one of our most improved patients. He's been with us for quite some time. I'm sure he'd be willing to show you around. Right, John?
Oh, yeah. I'll show him the whole nine yards.
I think it would be best if you stayed by his side for now.
There's not enough black tiles, you hear me? There's too many white tiles!
You know, Doc, our last session was so enlightening.
That's good to hear. Your next evaluation is in a few weeks. I'm glad you're starting to understand yourself better.
Oh, every day, Doctor.
Every day.
I can't taste anything! I want to taste!
You gotta be more careful, Bruce. Some of these guys bite. You remember the first time you let me into the rec room, Dr. Leland?
How could I forget?
You had to teach me how to play checkers.
Yes, well.
No, no, you need to let me go. I have to warn the president. They're trying to kill me.
You don't know the president.
No! They don't like it when you try to use the phone.
That's because phones are for staff use only. No exceptions.
Then stop that guy from trying. Such persistence.
Wrong number, dumbass!
Stop!
I don't need one. I'm better. Look.
I'll come by to check on you two later.
Don't worry about us, Dr. Leland. Just take good care of him.
Welcome to Arkham Asylum!
Believe it or not, some of these people are crazy. But everyone's friendly, mostly. I'd watch yourself around those two. Not a big fan of strangers. And just a little bit, you know, prone to outbursts of violence.
What did they do?
This is Arkham, Bruce! Use that sick little imagination of yours. Murder, mayhem, carnage, the usual. Let's see. On the couch, that's St. Louis. Ooh, shh. His favorite show's on. Never misses it. All right, friendo. Commercial break. Get up! Where is the remote? One of the orderlies must have taken it. Never fear, though. I'll go ask Leland. She likes me. Ooh! I almost forgot. Here.
What is this? The right key for this. Hey, I was wondering about...
It's not lunch yet.
Well, actually,
and
I wasn't...
It's not time for meds either. Beat it.
If that's the way the cookie crumbles... Crumbs! That's it!
You got a bad case of the mind knives. I can tell. I can tell. Just shove off, all right? No mind knives for me. I already got my shots.
I solved the cookie riddle, not you!
Sorry. It's...
Batman really did a number on this guy. Just let him be. Hey there, buddy boy. You missed me? I missed you.
However, the threat remains. The children of Arkham are still out there, and I will not rest until these streets are safe and firmly under my control.
Never anything good on, is there?
your key. It didn't work.
Of course not.
That's not how you get out of here. You tried it, though, didn't you? That's hilarious.
My enforcement squad has already seen great success. They stopped a massive attack being organized out of a local SkyTrain depot.
Politicians usually bore me to tears, but this one
has become a lot more interesting lately.
In my Gotham, no one's above the law, including Bruce Wayne. After his vicious attack on Oswald Cobblepot, I had Mr. Wayne committed to Arkham Asylum, where I hope he'll receive the treatment he so desperately needs.
Double-crossing, two-faced. I thought you and the mayor were friends. I mean, you were supporting his campaign. I saw all sorts of photos of the two of you together.
Oh, well, you had a good run, right?
Harvey was my friend. I can't believe he's the one who put me here.
Sounds like you need better friends. Slim pickings around here, though. I've looked.
In which Mayor Dent announced the creation of a special enforcement squad under his direct command to combat an imminent threat from the children of Arkham.
Rest assured, we will find these terrorists, their stockpile of drugs, and their leader, this Lady Arkham, before they can strike again.
Now, this is good television! Mayor on a rampage versus freaky drug terrorist.
I'm gonna find your drugs.
I'm going to expose your corruption.
Oh my god! Won't someone save my baby?
Lady Arkham is dangerous. Way more dangerous than you think.
Oh, I know a bit about Lady Arkham. Let me tell you.
Tragically, there's still no sign of Gotham Gazette reporter Vicki Vale after her mysterious disappearance earlier this week.
Very tricky, Vicki. I think we both know she's quite the lady, right, Bruce?
Wait, you know that Vicki is... Tell me what you know.
You want to find Vicki and her drugs, huh? Get your revenge just like you got your revenge on Cobblepot? Publicly and dramatically, something entertaining for these newscasters to talk about. Ooh, I'd love to see that.
I'm not doing anything for you. You got that?
That's unfortunate. It really is. I was looking forward to it for a moment there. I've been watching you for a while now, Bruce, and I can tell there's something darker in you. When you attacked Oswald, I could tell you enjoyed it. If those cops hadn't dragged you off of him, that Cobblepot punk would be dead!
That wasn't me. I was just pumped full of her drugs.
Those just amplify what you're already feeling, what's already inside. Don't be ashamed. It's in your blood. I see a lot of your father in you.
She probably does too.
It's obvious that's why Vicki hates you.
Your dad helped bump off her parents.
Why would my father have the Vales killed?
I never said he killed the Vales.
She was born in Arkham. Victoria Arkham.
What?
You didn't know that? The Arkhams did not approve of what your dad and his partners were doing. They were gonna blow the whistle on the whole thing, so your dad, well, pop, pop. Her parents murdered, leaving her with an unquenchable thirst for vengeance. Surely you can relate. Tragedy can drive people to do some pretty dark stuff.
Don't try to make this about me.
Of course it's about you, Bruce. This is all about you. You and Vicki are both dark souls.
wheels, and now you're heading on a collision course towards each other. That's gonna be fantastic!
You see, I know what you really are.
And that's why I really want to tell you where Vicky's moved her drugs, but you're not gonna do anything while you're stuck in here. So, I vote we get you out. How hard can it be? You're Bruce Wayne.
The Waynes always get what they want.
All it would take is a phone call.
Well, sure, but there's no phone.
Assume I can take care of that. But it's gonna come at a price. When I get out of here, you're gonna owe me a favor, okay? Just one. I don't know what it is yet. But what's one favor between friends?
Let's be clear about one thing. You are never, ever getting out of this place.
Whatever you say, Bruce. But never is a very, very long time. All right, tell you what, I'm gonna make a distraction to get the guards away from that gate. The rest is up to you. You make that phone call, and I promise I'll tell you how to find those missing drugs.
Hey, Zaz! Hello, Zaz.
What the hell do you want?
Settle a bet. What happens if you make a tally mark before you kill someone?
What are you talking about? Ah! No!
No, I don't match anymore.
Oh god, I don't match!
You can fix that right now!
Skin feels like it's itching. Burning! Need to get rid of it!
Stop! Someone get me a sedative!
Run, Brucey! Run!
Damn it! Call security!
GCPD.
Gordon, it's Bruce Wayne.
Wayne? Aren't you supposed to be in Arkham Asylum?
Listen, Gordon, I haven't lost my mind. I was drugged. The same drug the Children of Arkham used on Montoya and Harvey Dent. You get me out of here, and I'm willing to testify.
This might help our case, actually. That makes three victims now, and Renee says she's got some new evidence. If you're willing to testify, I think I can get you out of there.
Thanks. I have to go.
Oh, Bruce, I have not had this much fun in ages.
Let me tell you how to find Vicky's stash of missing drugs. Ask the Veils.
Quickly, come on.
Get the lock on the outside, Bruce.
I just know you're gonna put on quite a show.
Pretty grisly scene in there. Multiple stabbings. One of the orderlies had a finger bitten off.
Doctor, I swear to you, I was not involved in any of this.
We're going to look into it further before I feel comfortable making a decision one way or the other. One moment. Seems you have a visitor.
Alfred.
Bruce, thank heavens you're all right.
You see everything is in order. Signed this morning with Lieutenant Gordon of the GCPD. He is to be released into my care.
I know it seems like using your power and influence is the best way to make this all go away. But it's just avoiding the problem. What happened with those men in your room? The riot with Zaz? You clearly need help, Bruce. He needs extensive evaluation, treatment.
I think I'll get a second opinion.
Yeah, I'm sure you can afford the one you like.
Let's go, Alfred.
I will see you on the outside, Bruce.
I can't wait!
What was that about?
Well, I just can't believe that Lady Arkham was actually Vicky Vale this entire time.
And all the while she was working with Cobblepot to try and bring me down.
Did Lieutenant Gordon hear about this lead when he let you out?
Not yet. Batman will handle this one first.
Even during Batman's brief hiatus, Gotham has become that much more dangerous. And the public opinion on Bruce Wayne... Well, it certainly hasn't gotten any better.
Yeah, well, that's why it's Batman's turn now.
True, I suppose public opinion doesn't affect him much. Though, if the people protesting to have you thrown back in Arkham get their way, that could put a damper on things.
Hello, Harvey.
You should have stayed in the asylum where I put you.
What do you want, Harvey?
The streets of Gotham are a dangerous place for someone like you right now. Well, you'll figure that out. Eventually.
I'll be fine, Harvey. I can handle myself.
I don't think you understand the danger you're in. Maybe you haven't heard, but the children of Arkham have gone underground. Obviously plotting some sort of attack, and people are scared. Panicking. I needed to show them that my resolve hasn't weakened. That Gotham is still strong. So I gave them an enemy. You and your family's filthy corruption. The last thing I need is you traipsing around Gotham.
Harvey, how about we just agree to go our separate ways, all right?
You think you can just walk away from me? Just like that, after everything you've done? Can't let you keep running around scot-free, Bruce. It's the will of the people.
You can spare me your will of the people crap, Harvey. I know this is personal.
You knew I was interested in Selina. What you did was a low blow, Bruce. A real man wouldn't have done that. A friend wouldn't have done that.
She doesn't belong to you, Harvey. She can see whoever she wants.
Do not lecture me about Selina. Bruce! Bruce!
We're done talking. What's going on here?
Well. Bruce Wayne. You really must have done something to piss the mayor off so much, hmm? Maybe I'll get a bonus for this. Open the trunk. We're searching the car. Now, if we find anything tying you to the children of Arkham, including drugs, weapons, or any other suspicious materials, you will be taken into custody.
I know my goddamn rights, and you better have a warrant to back that up.
Don't need one. Mayor Dent gave his enforcers full search and seizure rights.
Come on, what's the damn holdup?
Get back to your car!
Of course. Should've known. Go back to Arkham, you damn maniac!
The hell?
Careful, or you'll be the next Cobblepot.
Showing your face in public like this? Not real smart.
You can still leave.
and I would take advantage of that while both your kneecaps are still attached correctly.
Someone else heard that, right? This psycho just threatened me!
Yeah, I filmed the whole thing!
They should lock you up!
Oh, God. Alfred, I'm sorry.
You'll be fine. We just need to get out of this mess.
Nowhere to run, dirtbag!
Next one won't be a warning shot!
All right, now the way I see it, there are two ways we can do this, Bruce Wayne. Either I let these people at you and see how you handle mob justice, or you could make a little donation to me and my boys to help us stay well-funded, and well-armed. What do you say?
They've got us blocked in. I can't back up.
This is turning ugly, sir. What would you like to do?
Hey, the mayor's gonna hear about this, and it ain't gonna make him happy.
Hey, he's the problem, not us!
Back off! Back off, people!
Here. It's everything I have, okay?
Sure, that'll work.
This isn't over.
Yeah, sure. Take it up with City Hall.
What do you mean you're leaving?
Bruce, Harvey's clearly lost it. All over the news yelling about how you need to be brought to justice, throwing whoever he wants in jail. Not really interested in seeing what he has planned for me. I was supposed to be here laying low. Does this look like laying low to you?
You don't need to worry about Harvey. I'll protect you from him.
Don't write checks you can't cash. Don't you get it, Bruce? Harvey catching you in my apartment drove him completely around the bend.
So you're saying you think his breakdown is our fault?
Yeah? Don't get me wrong, Bruce. The night was a lot of fun, but not worth dying for. He's dangerous. You understand, don't you?
Okay, don't you think you're being just a little overdramatic? Harvey wouldn't kill you.
No? Look what he's done to you. And you're the type of person who shows up in headlines. He could have me killed and no one would ever know.
So where are you gonna go?
I got some other business I need to take care of.
What other business?
Look at yourself, Bruce. You're in no shape to take on Harvey. Or the children of Arkham, for that matter. Of course. That's my car. See you around. Good luck with all of this.
Need to get to the computer.
You're exhausted. And the influence of Lady Arkham's drug may still be affecting you.
Harvey is turning Gotham into a police state. Oswald has stolen my company, and we need to find Vicky and the children of Arkham before they strike again. I can't just ignore it.
You're in no condition to work. You absolutely must get some rest.
Then help me. Feels like the whole damn cave is coming down around me.
Of course I'll help. Let's start by addressing the problem at hand.
You're right. Let's just focus on getting my head clear first. Bring up everything we know about Vicky Vale's drug.
Yes, of course.
If I can isolate the presence of the drug, I should be able to synthesize an antidote. Start a DNA scan. Compare it to my DNA on file in the back computer.
I'll make the preparations.
This is the refined sample of the drug taken from Officer Montoya after she killed Falcone. Here's my DNA before the incident. It seems that the drug attaches itself to specific proteins in the genome structure. If we can modify the drug's molecular structure, we should be able to create a counteragent.
Once you've figured this out, we'll have a working antidote. We can cure others affected by the drug.
No. I wish that were possible. This cure is based on my DNA. It'll only work for me. To cure other people, we'd have to sample and decode. That should do it. This needs to be injected directly into the vein to work.
I don't imagine it'll be much fun. Hopefully that does the trick.
It'll work, Alfred. Feel better already.
So, what are we going to do now?
First things first, I need to know what Vicky, Lady Arkham, has been up to while I've been away. Search for all children of Arkham recent activity. The press is reporting that Vicky Vale is missing.
Yes, and obviously the police have yet to find a body.
That woman, trying to get the scoop on you, pretending to care. She betrayed you.
I wish things had been different. Maybe I could have gotten through to her.
You always try your best, Bruce. She had her own agenda from the start.
She was playing me the entire time, breaking me down. She wanted me in Arkham. She wanted me to feel what my father had done to all those people.
Bruce.
There were bigger plans than me, Alfred. Batman stopped her at the Skyrail station. And I can't believe that she isn't finding another way to use the drugs.
Well, if that's true, she may be more dangerous than ever.
I know. I met someone in Arkham who gave me a tip on how to find her.
A tip? Do you really think you can trust someone in Arkham Asylum? No offense intended toward your recent time there, of course.
He knew that Vicky Vale was Lady Arkham. No one else has that information.
I suppose that's not something we can ignore, trustworthy or not.
He told me that if I want to know what she's planning, then I should visit her parents' house.
If the Vales still live in Gotham, they should be easy enough to locate.
Got it.
Bruce!
Yeah?
If you do find Miss Vale, please, be careful.
I'm inside the Vale House. Alfred, the Vales are dead. One body confirmed, but there is a lot of blood. Alert Gordon.
Will do.
I don't know how this is connected to the drugs yet. Whatever they knew about it, Vicky made sure they kept quiet. Syringe. Seems she hasn't given up her old tricks.
Is this the same drug?
Yes, but this is several times stronger than the dosage I received.
Maybe she's escalating.
This seems personal. Her eyes are gone. Stabbed out.
That's disturbing.
There's an injection wound on her neck. Same kind Montoya and I both received, but this one's much worse. Same device, same drug. This confirms that Lady Arkham is the murderer.
Recent family photo?
Vicky's not in it. It shows the Vales with another child in front of an industrial office. There's a logo on the building. It's clean. This wasn't used as a murder weapon.
Then why was it lying on the floor?
Alfred, found Mr. Vale.
Alive?
No. He's gone. 10 hours at least, judging by the state of his soft tissues. Looks like a company logo. The belt buckle is covered in blood. Before he was hung with the belt, Mr. Vale was beaten with it. The logos match. Mr. Vale owned an oil and heating company.
Looking it up now. Yes, he's got a sizable warehouse in the industrial district and a fleet of delivery trucks.
And now Vicky's got it. Found a lock of hair.
Anything unique about it?
It was cut at a downward angle, probably with some force based on how clean the slice is. Appears Mrs. Vale attempted to fight back with this knife, but only managed to slice through the attacker's hair. It's a letter from Gotham Social Services about a monthly stipend for foster parents.
Vicky's a bit old for that, isn't she?
It's not for Vicky. They have a boy. This must be Vicky shortly after she was adopted.
Large amounts of blood spatter across the walls. It's not steady like arterial spray. Someone was swinging wildly. Wait, there's a slight indentation where something bloody struck the wall with force.
Something thrown.
Nothing I can see. The indentation matches the shape of the belt buckle. It must have impacted with the wall during the attack.
What exactly happened in that house?
I think I know. After we stopped her at the rail station, Vicky needed a place to hide her supply of drugs. Her father's trucks and warehouse offered the perfect cover. To do that, she needed them out of the way. With Vicky Vale fully assuming her new identity on Lady Arkham, seems like she didn't need the veils around to support her old one. Vicky showed up to attack her adopted parents, but only the mother was there at first. Miss Vale fought back and was able to slice off part of Vicky's hair. Vicky then subdued her with the same drug she used on me, but a much, much larger dose. Nearly lethal. She then removed the mother's eyes, indicating a deeply personal motivation. This was obviously some sort of vendetta. Sometime during this, Mr. Vale entered. Vicky attacked him with his own belt, striking with the buckle until he was unconscious and bleeding out. Finally, she dragged him to the closet and hung him with the belt. The blood loss got him way before the hanging did.
Horrific! She never acted out in such a violent way before. Why would she...
Alfred, I think someone's still in the house. Going to look for a heat signature. If anyone else is here, I'll find them. Clear. Nothing here. There's someone here, under the stairs, alive. It's okay. I'm not going to hurt you.
Sir, is everything all right?
It's a kid, Alfred. The boy from the photo.
Is he all right?
Aside from the shock and a few bruises, he seems okay. He might be able to tell me more about what happened.
Possibly. But if that's the road you go down, please do it with caution.
I need to know what happened.
No!
Tell me what you saw.
Go away!
Something bad happened out here. I know it might be scary, but I need your help. Can you do that?
Please, please just leave me alone.
I'm on your side.
Get down!
Figure out our next move. Figure out where the drugs are. Did I get it? Come on, ghost. Pathetic. I've got these little back traps all over the city, but I should have known a good double murder would be what brought you out in the open.
Are you safe? Were you wounded?
I'm okay. They're dead.
It'll be better if you don't look.
Oh.
I'm sorry.
They weren't always nice, but they gave me a place to live.
I promise. I won't stop until I catch the person that did this.
Batman!
Oh my God!
He was the only survivor.
Come on, let's get you out of here.
Batman won't hurt me, will he?
Oh, Jesus! Was this the Children of Arkham? Again? Why would they attack a family like the Vales?
Because their daughter Vicky is Lady Arkham. She killed her own parents so she could use their company warehouse to stockpile the rest of her drugs.
Vicky? Vicky Vale, the reporter? And so, who's the boy then?
He was hiding in a closet when the attack started. He may know more than he realizes.
Thanks for the heads up.
The warehouse is Vale Oil and Heating. You should secure it as soon as possible.
I'll get on it right away. What about you?
I've got something I need to look into.
Lieutenant, what's going on here?
Securing the crime scene, Commissioner.
Not anymore, you're not. I'm taking over this investigation. I can't risk you allowing Batman to contaminate our crime scene again.
So your bat stunner just didn't work?
That's right. I have a bad feeling it was no accident. Alfred, get Lucius on the line for me, please. Let's get a closer look at you. No damage on the microfiber. Adhesion regulation reads normal. Electricity conductor, everything looks functional. It should have worked. EMP functionality is all in the green. This doesn't make any sense. This is strange. This microchip is emitting a low bandwidth receiving signal, but it shouldn't be.
Like the ones you shut down in the GCPD.
Something like that. But Lucius had his eyes on the Wayne tech that the Children of Arkham breached. This is something different.
Bruce, I have Lucius on screen now.
Good evening, Bruce. How can I help?
I need you to see something. Sending you schematics.
God, someone's found a way to get past my security upgrades.
Not just someone. Oswald Cobblebot.
Bruce, I am so sorry. I should have caught this, but he snuck right under my nose. Oh, what a mess. That sleaze Cobblepot at the heart of it all.
Cut yourself some slack, Lucius. There's no way you could have known. I certainly don't blame you for it.
Well, I still feel a little guilty. Looks to me like he's introduced some sort of bug into your network.
That's how he's making my equipment malfunction?
For now. But if he keeps it up, he could completely take control of your tech.
My lord, that would be catastrophic.
Is there anything you can do?
I can try to work on your firewalls. But if I do anything too drastic, he'll know we're onto him.
I'm tired of being on the defensive. Why don't we attack him instead?
I'm not sure, but I can certainly see what I can do.
Thanks, Lucius.
Bruce, you're going to want to see this.
Excuse us, Lucius.
Of course.
Reports of Children of Arkham activity are down. But these efforts do not come cheap. That's why I am formally seizing the Wayne estate, so the corrupt wealth of Gotham's elite can go to the better purpose of protecting Gotham's common man. Mr. Wayne has 24 hours to evacuate his property and turn it over to the city, or he will be removed.
You can't let that egomaniac throw us out on the street.
I have to talk to him.
After what happened at the debate, Harvey probably isn't the biggest fan of Batman. On the other hand, perhaps Bruce Wayne can appeal to him on a more personal level.
Harvey's behavior is unpredictable. Random. Who knows how he will react either way?
This is Bruce's problem, not Batman's. I'll take care of it.
I believe in you, Bruce. I know you can get through to him.
I don't know if that was the right thing to do. Why did I do that?
Don't screw this up, Harvey.
Harvey, we need to talk.
If you've come to save your home, you're wasting your time. My mind is made up.
How much is it going to cost to change your mind?
You really think everything is a negotiation, don't you? Well, this isn't. I'm taking your home from you, Bruce.
Look, I know you're still pissed off at me about sleeping with Selina. I get it. But this has to stop. Now.
Gotham deserves a mayor that can focus on cleaning up this city. That's why I'm taking your money, your home, everything.
It's time that you started paying your debt to Gotham. The value of your estate, it could be used to do a lot of good.
It's not my debt to pay. What my parents did was not my fault.
Nobody cares. The deal is done. A strong leader doesn't back down. When they see an enemy, they crush them without hesitation. I made a promise to the city that I would make it better. That I would weed out the crime and corruption.
You're really living up to your campaign slogan, aren't you, Harv? A new face for Gotham.
Is that supposed to be funny? You won't be laughing after you see what I'm about to do to the Children of Arkham.
What are you talking about?
Ready to go.
Do it.
What the hell did you do?
Our Lady Arkham's drugs destroyed.
Oh man, that blast was way bigger than you said! We must have taken out a whole city block with it! Man, we lost a bunch of our own guys! The apartment next door! Oh, Jesus Christ!
We stopped the Children of Arkham. That's all that matters. That's what a leader does.
Does a leader kill innocent people? You're a murderer now.
Their deaths are unfortunate. But think about everyone the Children of Arkham could have hurt with those drugs. That feels like an acceptable price to pay. I couldn't just destroy the drugs. I had to make a statement. I needed the Children of Arkham and any other potential enemies waiting in the shadows to know what I'm capable of. That I'll do anything to protect my city.
After what you've done tonight, everyone in Gotham is going to see who they really elected mayor. And when that happens, they will turn against you.
On the contrary, Bruce. This is what Gotham wanted. Oh, I can see tomorrow's headlines already. Hero Mayor, save citizens from Children of Arkham terror plot. Meanwhile, somewhere in the back they'll stick the article about Bruce Wayne's tragic suicide.
What the hell are you talking about?
All the shame you've suffered was just too much for you to bear. Your family's history, getting forced out of your company, losing all your money. No one will question finding you dead in Crime Alley so soon after you got out of Arkham. Tragic, but unsurprising. Maybe even dear old Alfred will shed a tear. I hope that was satisfying. That's the last one you get.
Come on, keep walking.
Wait. Shut up!
Just wait.
Just keep moving.
Please, why are you doing this?
Hey, he said shut up!
You're cops! You're supposed to protect people, keep them safe! Is this really what your badge stands for?
This is how we're keeping people safe. The Children of Arkham are trying to tear the city apart. We're saving it.
Yeah, we finally got a leader who wants results.
Listen to yourself. You sound brainwashed.
No, it hasn't brainwashed us. We're helping it. We're doing the right thing.
The mayor's the only one brave enough to take real action against our enemies.
Your mayor just blew up a city block.
Sometimes to help the greater good, there's a price to pay.
People died. Your fellow officers died.
But
if you think that's where he's gonna stop, you're just as crazy as he is.
Maybe he has a point.
Shut up! You just don't get it. You don't understand. That's why we need to take you out.
Maybe.
Maybe what?
Nothing.
Just think for yourselves. You're not Harvey's puppets. You are more than
this
that.
This isn't about the mayor. This is about protecting the city. And that's why we're not afraid to do what it takes.
Officer, drop your weapon. You okay?
Yeah. You really showed up in the nick of time. How'd you even find me? Dent just blew up a whole city block.
I know. The reports I'm hearing are just awful. Dent's gone way, way too far. He's supposedly trying to stop the Children of Arkham, but now he's become a goddamn terrorist himself. A terrorist with half the city's support behind him. The amount of blood on his hands. He and Lady Arkham might be neck and neck on body count by this point.
Dent needs to be stopped, Jim. Now. Or that block won't be the last thing that gets destroyed.
No, we'll stop him. But it ain't gonna be easy. It's a mess out there. I can't help but feel guilty. Batman gave me the information on where to find Lady Arkham's drug stockpile. I handed it into my superiors and... God, this happens. I'm trying to figure out what I can do to help. But I feel like my hands are tied every direction I turn. Grogan's out for Batman's head, as soon as he can figure out a way to do it. I've never felt this frustrated with a system in my entire career.
Sounds to me like you're already on the right path. Weeding the bad seeds out of the department. Cutting down the enforcers.
Yeah, I just hope it'll be enough. Everything is such a goddamn mess. Do you need a ride?
Thanks, but I've got it taken care of.
Lucius, what's the situation?
I figured out how he's causing the feedback loop. He's somehow connected a black box computer to your encrypted network. God, it's like a digital battering ram. If he keeps this up, he could smash through the Batcave firewalls at any minute.
He'd have access to the Bat computer. Hang on, Lucius. It's Alfred. I'm patching him in. Al, Lucius figured out how Penguin's cracking my security. He has a device that...
I'm afraid we have another problem to deal with. Mr. Dent is pulling up to the manor as we speak, and he's not alone.
Already?
Sir, are you all right?
Penguin's hacking assaults are getting worse. At this rate, he'll have my tech compromised by the end of the night. Only place he could be hacking me from is Wayne Enterprises.
Well, I don't envy your position. Even Batman can't be in two places at once.
I'm going home.
Understood. See you soon. Not one step further.
Now, come on, Al. Put the rifle down. I'm not gonna hurt you.
Somehow, I don't believe you.
Back away, please, all of you.
Jesus, Al, it's me, Harvey.
No, not the Harvey I know. The Harvey I know would never have massacred innocent civilians. He isn't a murderer.
When a general sends his troops to kill the enemy, no one calls it murder.
They call it war.
Penguin is still hacking my tech. Win the war against Guess the I'll be doing this the old-fashioned way.
What are you doing here?
You've destroyed enough lives for one night. I'm taking you in.
Oh, I get it. You'll come to Bruce Wayne's aid when he needs it, but not mine. No, not when I needed it. You let that maniac Penguin maim me! Look at me! This happened under your watch! And you call yourself a hero.
You're not the victim here, Dent.
Oh, and Bruce is. Ha! Newsflash! I already took care of that rich prick. He's dead. If you can't see the good I've done for this city, then you're no better than Lady Arkham. Or the Waynes. Now get out of here! Before I have you booked for obstruction of justice. You stand in my way. You stand in the way of the law.
You're gonna need more than this, Harvey.
I know.
You know what those are?
Explosive slugs! Bet you don't have any of those in that little belt of yours. Just try and hide, Batman! See how that works out for you.
bat's mine. Use your head, Harvey. Killing me won't make you a hero. This old man needs to die. Your head or your heart? What's that sound?
What the?
Get the hell off me! Understand, Batman. Without me, Gotham is doomed. Who will stop Lady Arkham? The Penguin.
As long as I'm around, Gotham will be fine. They don't need someone like you.
No. I'm important. I'm important!
God, he was finally stopped. Nice work, Batman.
My job's not done yet. I still need to find Lady Arkham before it's too late.
Well, I can take care of all this. Just need to figure out what to do with him. All the innocent lives he's responsible for, he should be locked up in Blackgate Prison. But that broken mind of his will probably only get worse in there.
Den is too dangerous and too damaged to be kept in some holding cell at Blackgate. You have to get him into Arkham. They might actually be able to help him in there.
Yeah, you're right. I'll see what I can do. In the meantime, you stay safe out there, all right?
You too, Jim.
Al, what's wrong?
Bruce, the computer!
It's Penguin. We need to cut the hardline now!
Bruce, all of your bat tech is linked to this computer. If you take it offline, it will all be inoperable.
If Penguin hacks in, he'll have control of all of it. I have to shut it down!